My name is Helen. In this What Is section, we are going to talk about the light microscope. The light microscope, or the compound light microscope, I should say, is the must-have equipment in a laboratory. As a lab technician, this is obviously something you will use every day. A microscope is a very powerful tool, but in order to use it properly, you need a basic understanding of its components.
Why have scientists agreed on calling this instrument a microscope?
Good question indeed. First, you should know that micro means small and scope means view. So microscope means viewing small objects that the human eye cannot normally observe alone. You should also know that a standard compound light microscope, the one you have on your lab bench, can magnify objects about 1,000 times.
How small do the objects have to be so we can study them?
Light microscope is a useful tool for studying object ranging in size from 1 millimeter to about 200 nanometers.
A light microscope? What does it mean?
Light does obviously not refer to the weight of the microscope, but to the visible light it uses to illuminate the object you want to observe. When working in a biology lab, the object is called a specimen.
You called it a compound microscope. Why is that?
Good question indeed. A compound microscope is composed of multiple parts or components. Now, in order to use it properly, you need to know what these different components are. So let's discover them. But before we go any further, make sure your lab bench area is cleared of any notebooks, textbooks, or papers. The part of the microscope that lies on the bench is the base, and always handle the microscope with care. One of the most important parts of a compound light microscope is, well, the light source. The power switch is found at the base of the microscope, so make sure to switch it on. Sometimes you can adjust the intensity of the light using a slider. The next part is the stage. The stage is the flat area that holds the slide. At the center of the stage is a hole that allows the light to pass through. It also has stage clips to hold the slide in place.
There is a knob below the stage. What's it for?
Good point. The knob is the stage control, so you can look at different parts of your slide without having to move your hand. You may also have noticed another part below the stage. This is the condenser. It concentrates the light on the specimen. You can also adjust the diaphragm to get more or less light. Let's move on to the next part, the objectives. Most compound microscopes have 3 or 4 objectives, which are attached to the nose piece.
What is the number written on the side of the objectives?
The number indicates how much the object is magnified. For example, if you see the number 10 and the letter X written on the side of the objective, it means the object is magnified 10 times.
How does it work? What is inside the objective to magnify the specimen?
Inside each objective, there is a lens. This lens corresponds to the magnifying unit of the objective. To zoom in or out, revolve the nose piece. It means rotate the nose piece. This is how you can switch from one objective to another. Notice this is why the nose piece is called the revolving nose piece. The next magnifying part of the microscope is the eyepiece. It is connected to the objectives by the body tube. The eyepiece generally has a magnification power of 10 times.
It means that a microscope has 2 magnifying units. How is the total magnification calculated?
What an interesting question. As a matter of fact, the total magnification achieved by a microscope is calculated by multiplying the magnifying power of the objective by the magnifying power of the eyepiece.
So, the total magnification of a microscope ranges from 100 to 1,000 times?
Yes, indeed. It looks like you're good at math too.
Okay, so far so good, but is there any knob to bring the slide into focus?
Of course there is. You obviously want to get the best possible image, hence you need to adjust the focus. You may have already noticed more knobs. One is the coarse adjustment knob, and the other is the fine adjustment knob.
I guess they don't have the same purpose.
Of course they don't. The coarse adjustment knob, the bigger one, will move the stage up and down, bringing the slide closer or further from the lens. Once you get an image about the range of focus you need, you can use the fine adjustment knob, the smaller one, to get it just right. Now that you know almost everything about the compound light microscope, it is up to you to practice. To carry the microscope, grasp the microscope's arm with one hand. Place your other hand under the base. Now you are ready to study cells and other microorganisms, and who knows, you may even discover new species.